Hello everyone, my name is Alifia Magar and this is an assignment of media advocacy where I will be presenting my scheme. The scheme that I've taken up is Startup India. Startup India was announced by Prime Minister Narendra Modi on August 15, 2015, but it was launched on 16th January 2016. Startup India reports to Department of Industrial Policy and Promotion, which falls under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. The key people behind this scheme are Suresh Prabhu and Piyush Goyal. There are three pillars of the scheme: simplification and handholding, funding support and incentives, academia partnership and incubation in the industries. The major objective behind forming the scheme was to create job creators rather than job seekers in a country like India. The flagship initiative aims at helping startups and catalyzing entrepreneurship. The major objectives of this flagship initiative include generation of employment, economic development, and motivating the youth for entrepreneurship. The eligibility for registration for Startup India has a few conditions. The company should either be a private limited company, a limited liability partnership, or a registered partnership. The company should not be more than 10 years old, and the turnover should not increase or exceed 100 crores. The company should not be a reconstruction of a previous firm. The idea, the major aim of the company should be innovation, development, or improvement of a product or service. If the company does not have an innovative idea but has a high potential of employment generation and wealth creation, it is still eligible for registration. The benefits of the scheme for the startups include self-certification. There is no inspection for the first 3 years, which reduces regulatory burdens on the startup. An environmental certification helps you to focus on your work. There is a single point of contact known as the Startup Hub, which is an online portal. There are tax exemptions on capital gains. According to an article published on 26 January 2019, 15,472 startups have been recognized by Startup India, out of which 13,176 startups have created 1,48,897 jobs for the youth, 45 of which have one or more women directors. The scheme empowers the youth by providing them a platform. Good and innovative ideas do not face a lot of problem with funding. The complete control of the product or the project is in the creator's hand, including the designing, the setting of the price, which is not possible if you're working for another company. According to TRAI, the teledensity is 76% in mobile penetration. Data-enabled mobile phones are the nature of startup business. Startups with mobile apps have an ever-increasing market to cater to. There is a lot of scope for sustainable business, especially in this emerging cities with a lot of economic growth. There is organized employability, where the labor force accounts for 5,30,000 people, which majorly fall under the age group of 30 years. The working age group between 18 to 56 years is likely to increase more than 64% by 2021. It is an asset for generating employment and increasing productivity. The major drawback or the major problem behind this scheme revolves around funding. Small Industries Development Bank of India, SIDBI, was set up in order to invest in venture capital funds for these startups. Unfortunately, they failed to raise that kind of funds that was required for the startups to flourish. Banks put up about 15% of the money, whereas 85% of the money required, which is to be brought on the table, is still a struggle. The venture capital had to be registered with the Security Exchange Board of India, SEBI, which wasn't followed, and the government had to shut them down, unfortunately. The tax benefits: startups don't usually profit immediately and may take up to 3 years after the establishment. Hence, the government extended the tax holiday to 5 years. To conclude, in the right environment, Indian market is a viable place to grow new businesses and ventures. Fewer tax regulations, restrictions, and limitations regarding fundings have risked the success of Startup India. The system has a lot of loopholes for it to be a complete success. Removal of red tapeism, getting rid of tax regulations, promoting an environment of employability and credibility, lasting salaries for workforces could be a few suggestions. So this was all about the scheme that I chose, Startup India. Thank you.